गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स,
गुड इवनिंग सर।
सो वी विल स्टार्ट द सेशन वेयर वी स्टॉप्ड यस्टरडे। यस्टरडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग सम न्यूमेरिकल बेस्ड ऑन ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक रेशियोस ऑफ स्पेशल स्टैंडर्ड एंगल्स। सो व्हाट आर द स्टैंडर्ड एंगल्स स्टूडेंट्स? एनीवन कैन गिव द ऑर्डर ऑफ द स्टैंडर्ड एंगल्स? व्हाट आर द स्टैंडर्ड एंगल्स? एनीवन प्लीज।
सर, 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree एंड 90 degree सर।
30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degrees एंड 90 degrees। सो आई एम टेकिंग 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, डिवाइडिंग विथ 4 एंड टेकिंग द रूट। सो व्हाट आर द वैल्यूज यू आर गेटिंग? दीज वैल्यूज आर करस्पॉन्डिंग टू साइन थीटा। If it is theta, sin theta. So this will be 0. I am taking a different color. It will be easy to this is 0. Sorry, it's not degree. This is 0. This is 1/2. This is 1/√2. This is √3/2. This is 1. I already told you for cos theta, no need to do it again. Reverse. Write the all the values of sine in reverse order. 1 √3/2, 1/√2, 1/2, 0. For tan theta, take sine by cos. 0/1 is 0. 1/2 by √3/2 is 1, 2 cancel. 1/√3. This is 1. This is √3. This is undefined. Or you can consider as 1/0. And rest of the three ratios, you know what I told. So for writing the cot theta, reciprocal of tan, this is undefined or 1/0, and this is √3. Reciprocal of 1 is 1. Reciprocal of 1/√3 is √3, and reciprocal of undefined is 0. And for secant theta, reciprocal of cot, cos, 1, 2/√3, √2, 2, undefined, because 0 reciprocal is undefined. For cosecant theta, reciprocal of sine. So sine 0 is 0. So undefined. Sine 30 is 1/2. This is 2. 1/√2 reciprocal is √2. √3/2 reciprocal is 2/√3. And 1 reciprocal is 1. This is how we can write all the standard angles of sine, cos, tan, cot, secant and cosecant from 0 to 90 degrees of standard angles. How to do 15 degrees? Some other standard angles is there that we will do in class 1. 15 degrees and 75 degrees, 33 and off, 22 and off, all those things we will do later. Yeah. So we'll see some numericals. I think we already started a few numericals over this. We've done first, evaluate the following. Out of first 5 numericals, we done first 4. Am I right, madam? Anyone? Yesterday we done first 4. Correct? Students, is there? Students, will you able to hear what I am doing?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. We done first 4. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
So we will do rest of the numericals and we will continue the topic. So here we are having cos 60, secant 30, tan 45. With the help of the table, please list out what is the cos 60? 1/2. Secant 30, 2/√3. Tan 45, 1. Sin 30, 1/2. Cos 30, √3/2. Substitute the values and let me know what is the answer. Students, please substitute the answers. Substitute these values and let me know. Simplify it. Everyone. Anyone got the answer? Students, please. Anyone got the answer? 5 cos square 60 is 1 by 2 whole square plus 4 secant square 30, 2 by root 3 whole square minus tan square 45, 1 square divided by 1 by 2 whole square plus straight away you can say sin square theta plus cos square. Yes, that is not it. Came 1 by 2 whole square plus root 3 by 2 whole square. This will be 5 by 4 plus 4 into 4 by 3 minus 1 divided by 1 by 4 plus 3 by 4. So in the numerator it is 5 by 4 plus 16 by 3 minus 1 divided by 1 plus 3 by 4 plus 4. This is 1. So finally I am getting 5 by 4 plus 16 by 3 minus 1. LCM is 12. So this is 15 plus 64 minus 12. What is the answer? Students, please respond. 67 by 12 is the right answer. Got the same answer or any different answer you got? Student, please. Yeah. We'll go to the next one. Choose the correct answer. MCQs. They gave the question, they gave the four options. We have to choose the right option. Question number one. They are asking the value of 2 tan 30 divided by 1 plus tan square 30. But the answers are a little bit different. They didn't give any value. They gave some other angle of some ratio. So tan 30 is how much? We know tan 30 is equals 1 by root 3. So this will be 2 into 1 by root 3 divided by 1 plus 1 by root 3 whole square. This is 2 by root 3 by 1 plus 1 by 3. 2 by root 3 by 4 by 3. This is this 2 times gone. And this is root 3 times. This is 1 by 2 by root 3, which is known as root 3 by 2. The final answer, I got the root 3 by 2. Which option is giving root 3 by 2? Sine 60 is giving root 3 by 2. So the correct option is A. The second one is 1 minus tan square 45 by 1 plus tan square 45. For second question, if we know the tan 45 value, it is enough to complete this question. It is equal to 1. So 1 minus 1 by 1 plus 1. This is 0 by 2. Answer is 0. So the second option is 0. Sine 2a is equal to 2 sine a is true when a is equal. Third question. They gave sine 2a is equal to 2 times sine a. It is equal to 2 times sine a. It is true when a is equal. Students, how to do this question? Any idea? So whenever these kind of questions are coming, actually in plus one, we are having a different strategy. We will use different equation, but here just take the values. First option is 0 degrees. So sine 0 is equal to 2 sine 0. Yes, it is true. If I'm taking second option is 30 degrees. So that is sine 60 is equal to 2 sine 30. It's coming root 3 by 2, but this side it is coming 1. So false. Sine 45 is 1 by root 2. Sine 90 is 1. So it is coming sine 2a. For fourth, third option, if I'm substituting third option 45 degrees here, sine 2a is equal to 2 sine a. This is sine 90. This is 2 sine 45. Sine 90 is 1. This is 2 into 1 by root 2. This is also wrong answer. Fourth option is 60 degrees. Sine 60 means sine 120, which is not part of our syllabus to calculate the sine 120 value. So definitely it is not. So the answer is A. It is possible only if A is equal to 0 in this case. When it comes to fourth question, 2 tan 30 divided by 1 minus tan square 30. So we know it's like a first question. How we will do from the first question? 2 into 1 by root 3 divided by 1 minus 1 by root 3 whole square. This is 2 by root 3 divided by 1 minus 1 by 3. So 2 by root 3 divided by 3 minus 1 by 3. So 2 by root 3 divided by 2 by 3. This is looking like a complex fraction. 2 by root 3 into 3 by 2. 2 cancel. This is root 3 times. So the whole option is coming as root 3. 1 by 2. Sine 60 is root 3 by 2. Tan 60 is root 3. Sine 30 is 1 by 2. This is not, this is not, this is not. So the right option is tan 60. So this is how we can able to do these questions. Clear? Shall we go to the next question? Students, please. Can go to the next question. Students, I can move to the next question or not? Harita, Janavi?
Yes, sir.
If tan of a plus b is equal to root 3 and tan of a minus b is equal to 1 by root 3, then find the value of a and b, and a plus b is less than 90 degrees and greater than 0 degrees. It is not negative and it is not greater than 90 also. Why this is given, you can understand only in plus 1, because in plus 1 we will deal the angles from 0 to 360. We won't deal only for one quadrant. We'll deal for all the full rotation of angles. We will deal what is the sine of 270 or sine 300 and all, we will discuss that. So first we will list out the given data. According to our knowledge, tan of a plus b is equal to root 3. That will be equal to tan 60. That means a plus b is equal to 60. Then I will get it is root 3. This is my first equation. Same as tan of a minus b is equal to 1 by root 3. This is equal to tan 30. That in place of a minus b, if I am keeping 30, then I will get 1 by root 3. So a minus b is equal to 30 degrees. So this is second equation. So if I'm adding equation 1 plus 2, I will get 2a is equal to 60 plus 30, 90. So my a is 45, which is lying in between 0 and 90. If with the help of a, so 45 plus b is equal to 60. From here, b is equal to 15 degrees, which is satisfying both the equations. If I want to verify my answer. So from here, A is equal to 45, B is equal to 15 is my answer. It's clear, students? I can move to the next question.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So next question is true or false. State whether the following are true or false, justify your answer. The first one is sine of a plus b is equal sine a plus sine b. If it is true, it should valid for all the angles. I'm taking a is equal to 30 degrees, b is equal to 60 degrees, because I don't know if it is not standard angles. I don't know how to calculate. Suppose if I'm taking LHS, sine of 30 plus 60 will be equal to sine 90, which is equal to 1. But when it comes to RHS, sine 30 plus sine 60, this is 1 by 2 plus root 3 by 2, which will coming as root 3 plus 1 by 2, which is not equal to 1. So LHS is not equal to RHS. So this statement is a false statement. This is my justification. So if it is true for any angle of A and B, it should be true. If I'm taking A is equal to 0 only, it is coming. But when I'm taking other than 0, any angle, it is not coming. If I'm taking 30 comma 30, it is not coming. If I'm taking 30 comma 60, it is not coming. If I'm taking A is equal to 45, B is equal to 45 also, it is not coming. Thus, left side 1 will come, the right side you will get 2 by root 2. Second is, the value of sine theta is increasing if as theta increases. So to understand this question, I am writing theta is equal to 0, sine theta is equal to 0. Theta is equal to 30, sine theta is equal to 1 by 2, approximately 0.5. Theta is equal to 45, sine theta is equal to 1 by root 2. 1 by root 2 means it is nothing but root 2 by 2, 1.414 by 2, which is giving approximately 0.707. Theta is equal to 60, then sine theta will be equal to root 3 by 2, that is sine 60, 1.732 by 2, which is approximately getting as 0.866. And theta is equal to 90, then my sine theta will be equal to 1. What is happening if theta is increasing, 0, 30, 45, 60, and 90? The sine theta is increasing or decreasing? Students?
Increasing, sir.
Increasing. So this is the true statement. Next one. The value of cos theta is increases as theta increases. Same. 0. So cos 0 is equal to 1. 30. Cos 30 is equal to root 3 by 2. Which is nothing but 0.1732866. 45. Cos 45 is equal to 1 by root 2, that is 0.707 approximately. And 60, cos 60 is equal to 1 by 2, 0.5. And 90, cos 90 is equal to how much? So if you are able to keep it in mind your tables right away without writing all these things, you can say if from 0 to 90 degrees, the values are going down 1 to 0. This is the cos theta values. This is the theta values. So if theta is increasing, cos theta is decreasing. So which will use, this is a false statement. Sin theta is equal to cos theta for all values of theta. It is also false statement. Suppose if I'm taking theta is equal to 30, it is true only if theta is 45, because sine 45 is equal to cos 45. Both are 1 by root 2. But if theta is equal to 30, your sine theta will become 1 by 2. Cos theta will become root 3 by 2, which is sine 30 is not equal to cos 30. But he is saying for all values of theta, sine is equal to cos. This is also false statement. Cot A is not defined for A is equal to 0. What is the cot A? Cot 0 degrees is how much? 1 by tan 0, that is 1 by 0, which is known as undefined. So the fifth one is a true statement. Students, understood how to analyze a numerical? If you are having a table in mind, it will be very easy to go and to do any kind of numericals in a easiest manner. Next one. Yes, all the questions completed. Complementary angles are there in the syllabus?
Sir, it is revised portion, sir.
No, it's not there, no? Then?
No, sir.
So straight away we will move to the trigonometric equations. After that, I will explain the complementary angles concepts. Last time permits, I will explain, or and time not permits also, I will explain the complementary angles. First, we will complete scope of the syllabus first. Next one is trigonometric identities. Identities is nothing but which is true for any values. That is called identity. It won't change its identity if any variables are changing in it. So we will start to form the trigonometric identities with Pythagoras theorem itself. Suppose if I'm taking a right angle triangle, where right angle at B and my reference angle is theta. With the help of previous classes, you can able to define all the six ratios. What is sine theta? What is cos theta? What is tan theta? And anyone, what is sine theta here? AB by AC. Cos theta? BC by AC. From here, tan theta and all you can able to define, because tan theta is nothing but sine by cos, cosecant is 1 by sine, secant is 1 by cos, cot is 1 by tan, or cos by sine, or cosecant by secant. It's a variation. So I am applying the Pythagoras theorem for this triangle. Anyone can give the statement what you will get from the Pythagoras theorem, students? Students, please. If I am applying the Pythagoras theorem, what statement will get? I am applying the Pythagoras theorem, what you will get? Students, please. I am applying Pythagoras theorem this triangle, what you will get? Any are here? No one is responding.
Say AB square plus BC square equal to AC square.
AB square plus BC square is equal to AC square. Yeah, this is a one standard identity from the Pythagoras theorem. I'm applying for any right angle triangle, for any length of the right angle triangle, it is true. That's the reason this is also called an identity. How I can convert this equation into trigonometric ratios? Divide this Pythagoras theorem statement. Divide equation 1 with AC square on both sides. If I'm dividing both sides, what I will get? AB by AB square by AC square plus BC square by AC square is equal to AC square by AC square. So this will be equal to 1. I'm getting a standard identity in terms of lengths. AB by AC whole square plus BC by AC whole square is equal to 1. But from the definitions of trigonometric ratios, AB by AC can be replaced as sine theta whole square plus cos theta whole square. Here I am not taking any particular value, where AB, BC, AC are the any lengths which is related to a one single right angle triangle. So this can be write in a comfort way, sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Is my first identity. So this identity, why I am calling this identity? It won't change. The sum of the squares of the sine of an angle plus cos of the same angle is always unity. That's the reason it is called identity. It won't lose the identity if angle is changing. So that's the reason this is called an identity. For a given angle, sum of the squares of the sines and cos ratios is always equal to 1. You can verify with 30, you can verify with 45, or you can verify with 60 degrees, or even you can verify with 0 degrees also. Sine square 0 is 0, cos square 0 is 1. Sine square 30 is 1 by 4, cos square 30 is 3 by 4. So 1 by 4 plus 3 by 4 is 1. We've done some numericals related to these equations. Now, after knowing this equation, straight away you can apply this equation. Before exercise, we don't know about this equation. That's the reason I'm not applying. So now this is my standard equation. So with the help of the standard identity, some more identities I am trying to create. Because this is the identity is giving the relation between only sine square and cos. But we are having some other ratios, how to discuss these ratios. So this is a standard identity and equation one. So divide equation one with sine square theta on both sides. This will become sine square theta by sine square theta plus cos square theta by sine square theta is equal to 1 by sine square theta. This will be sine square theta by sine square theta is 1. Cos square by sine square theta can be written as cos theta by sine theta whole square, which will be equal to 1 by sine square theta is cosecant square theta, because 1 by sine is cosecant. This can be written as 1 plus cos by sine is 1 by tan, that is nothing but cot square theta is equal to cosecant square theta. This is my second identity, which I am deriving from the first identity only. Just I am dividing both sides with one particular ratio. This is my second identity. Same equation one with cos square theta. Divide equation one with cos square theta on both sides. From here, what I will get? Look into this. So my identity is sine square theta divided by cos square theta plus cos square theta divided by cos square theta is equal to 1 by cos square theta. If I am dividing the standard statement with cos square, sine by cos is tan. So this will give tan square theta, cos by cos is 1, 1 by cos is secant square. So this is my third identity. These are the standard identities. Why these are called standard identities? Here also 1 is equal to cosecant square minus cot square. Here also 1 is equal to secant square minus tan square. So for any given angle, these ratios are always equal to some constant. That's the reason these are called identities. So if I'm listing out these three identities, it will be easy to remember. Sine square theta plus cos square theta will be equal to 1. Tan square theta plus 1 is equal to secant square theta. Cot square theta plus 1 is equal to cosecant square theta, or like this you can write. In mind, you can able to divide with sine square and cos square. 1 plus cot square theta will be equal to cosecant square theta. These are the three standard identities. From these identities, we are going to do some numericals. These three equations we are calling as trigonometric identities. Anyone having any doubts in these identities, how I got, why I'm calling these are the identities, please let me know, guys. Before going to the numericals over this, students, please respond. Are you clear why I am calling these are the identities? Students, shall I go for some numericals based on this?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So the numericals are like algebra. Instead of x and y, they will give ratios without values. So they will ask us to prove LHS is equal to RHS and all. There are different strategies. In trigonometry, one question having many solutions, a few solutions having easiest way, rest of the solution will take a little bit longer time. So careful when you're doing the things. So right identity will help you to solve the question in easiest way. So I'm going to start. Express the trigonometric ratios of sine A, secant A in terms of cot A. It's a strange question. The same question we will discuss in grade 11 also. The question what he is asking is, express the trigonometric ratios of sine A, secant A and tan A in terms of cot A. I want sine A, which is combination of some cots. The sine A should be equal to combination of some cots. So we are having the three identities. Sine square theta, suppose in place of theta, if I am taking A, sine square A plus cos square A is equal to 1, and 1 plus tan square A is equal to secant square A, and 1 plus cot square a is equal to cosecant square a. So, but they gave the sign and they are asking convert sine completely into cots. Sine a. Is there any relation sine to cot? No. But sine to cosecant relation is there. Cosecant to cot relation is there. Sine to cosecant relation. Sine a can be written as 1 by cosecant a. What is the cosecant a here? Cosecant a can be written as 1 by root of 1 plus cot square a. So the sine a in terms of cot a is 1 by root of 1 plus cot square a. This is how we can write sine a in terms of cot. How to write secant a in terms of cot? Is there any relation between secant and cot? No. Secant to tan, tan to cot we have to go. We know secant a will be 1 plus tan square a under the root. But I want secant in cot. So 1 plus tan a can be written as 1 by cot a whole square under the root. So this will give 1 plus cot square a under the root divided by cot a is the final answer. This will come like this. Cot square a plus 1 divided by cot square a. So I don't want to change this is into cosecant because the question is asking entire equation should be in cot. That's the reason I can write, I can remove the root in the denominator. So my secant a is coming as 1 plus cot square a under the root divided by cot a. So this is a secant in the form of cot. Tan in the form of cot. Tan a is nothing but 1 by cot a because reciprocal of tan is cot. Is it? Reciprocal of tan is cot and reciprocal of cot is tan. So this is how the three questions, I mean three expressions, three ratios I can able to express in cots. Sine in terms of cots, secant in terms of cots, tan in terms of cots. So these expressions, these identities giving a beauty, a ratio you can able to develop in any other ratios. A ratio you can able to express in any other ratios. I can express sine in terms of tan, sine in terms of cot, sine in terms of cosecant, sine in terms of secant, and sine in terms of cos also. So all those things we are going to see at the end of this exercise. I will give a how to write any ratio in terms of any other ratio. Suppose if I am asking secant, everything you have to write in terms of secant. Everything. Sine I want in tan. Sine I want in cos also I want in tan. Tan in tan is same. Like this, how we can write using the identities. We will see one more time. Second question also same. Write all the trigonometric ratios of A in terms of secant A. So I want sine in terms of secant, cos in terms of secant. Like that, all other ratios in terms of secant. Write all the trigonometric ratios. Sine A can be written as 1 minus cos square A under the root because sine square A plus cos square A is equal to 1. From here, cos square A is equal to 1 minus sine square A or sine square A is equal to 1 minus cos square A. I am taking this identity here. So, sorry, sine A. So, sine A can be written as 1 minus cos square A. We know cos reciprocal is secant. So, this can be written as 1 by secant A whole square. So, sine A in terms of secant is secant square A minus 1 under the root divided by secant A. This is how we can write sine A in terms of secant. Like that, he is asking all ratios. Cos A in terms of secant, 1 by secant A. Cos A in terms of secant. Tan A in terms of secant, we are having an identity. What is the identity? 1 plus tan square A is equal to secant square A. From here, tan square A can be written as secant square A minus 1. So from here, tan A is root of secant square A minus 1. So now I got tan A in terms of secant A. So once you got these three, it will be easy to write rest of things. Cosecant A is nothing but 1 by sine A, but I want everything in secant. So reciprocate of sine A answer is enough. So secant A by square root of secant square A minus 1. Secant A is equal to secant A. So no need to mention this one. Cot A is reciprocal of tan. Cot A is reciprocal of tan. We know tan A already derived here. This will be equal to 1 by secant square A minus 1. So this is how we can write rest of the ratios also in the form of secant. Guys, are you clear? Is it clear, students? Please respond.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So this is how you can write any ratio into any other ratio. So each and every ratio I can link up to remaining 5 ratios. So based on this, after the exercise, we will see some more extra questions based on these kind of questions. Next one is, so evaluate. So to understand this question, we need complementary angles. Even second question also related to complementary angles. So I'm skipping this question. If you know this complementary angles, then only you can able to do this question. Otherwise, you can't do. After teaching the complementary angles concept, I will come back to this question. So choose the current option and justify your choice. Nine secant square A minus nine tan square A is equal to how much? Between secant and tan, we are having a relation. What is the relation? 1 plus tan square A is equal to secant square A. So in place of secant, you write this expression. So the question one is 9 secant square A minus 9 tan square A is equal to. So 9 of 1 plus tan square A minus 9 tan square A. This will be 9 plus 9 tan square A minus 9 tan square A. It's cancel, answer is 9. Or you can take 9 common. It is coming tan square A secant square A minus tan square A. If I'm taking 9 common, secant square A minus tan square A. From the above expression, this expression is equal to 1. So like this also you can write. So the answer is 9. Next one is, so basic algebra is very important, students. You should not forget about that basic algebra. 1 plus tan theta plus secant theta into 1 plus cot theta minus cosecant theta is equal to how much? So here, little confusion. Sir, it is completely in tans and secant. It is completely cots and cosecants. One of the best suggestion, if you are unable to remember anything, straight away you convert everything into sine and cos. Straight away convert everything into sine and cos. If I'm converting everything into sine and cos, this will be 1 plus sine theta by cos theta plus 1 by cos theta, and this will be 1 plus cot theta is nothing but cos theta by sine theta minus 1 by sine theta. How it will looks? If I'm taking the ratio, this will be cos theta in the denominator. This will be cos theta plus sine theta plus 1. And into this will be sine theta plus cos theta minus 1 divided by sine theta. This is looking like this whole thing is 1 a x. This is y. It is looking like x minus x plus y into x minus y. This can be written as sine theta plus cos theta whole square minus 1 square divided by sine theta into cos theta. If I'm expanding that one, the sine theta plus cos theta whole square, this will be sine square theta plus cos square theta plus 2 sine theta cos theta minus 1 divided by sine theta into cos theta. So sine square theta plus cos square theta is 1. plus 2 sine theta cos theta minus 1 divided by sine theta into cos theta. So 1 cancel. Finally, I'm getting 2 sine theta cos theta by sine theta into cos theta. So cos sine sine cancel. So final option is 2. So for the second question, the option is 2. Sir, in case of MCQ, if I want to complete within a 1 minute, substitute theta is equal to 45 and do it. You will get the answer. Because it is an identity, even if you substitute any angle, you have to get the same answer. If I'm substituting theta is equal to 90, it is undefined situations will come. So don't take that situations. You take a defined situations and you can able to try. Because it is showing all the four options are showing constants. The meaning of constant means that a whole expression is an identity. For any angle of theta, you should get that value is always. That's the meaning of identity. Hope you are clear, guys.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Next question is secant A plus tan A is equal to 1 minus sin A. Secant A plus tan A. Third question, same. Convert everything into sin and cos. Secant A plus tan A into 1 minus sin A. So this is 1 by cos A plus sin A by cos A into 1 minus sin A. This LCM is cos. So 1 plus sin A by cos A into 1 minus sin A. So 1 plus sin A into 1 minus sin A is 1 minus sin square A divided by cos A. 1 minus sin square is nothing but cos square A divided by cos A. Cos square A is nothing but cos A into cos A divided by cos A. So cos cancel. Finally, the option is cos A. So D is the option. Last question. 1 plus tan square A by 1 plus cot square A. 1 plus tan square A divided by 1 plus cot square A. So 1 plus tan square, according to identity, this is secant square A and this will be cosecant square A. Secant by cosecant. What is the ratio of secant by cosecant? Anyone? This is 1 by cos square A divided by 1 by sin square A. Finally, I am getting this expression sin square A by cos square A, which is nothing but tan square A. So the answer is D option. Or the question cot you can convert into 1 by tan and you proceed. You will get the answer. Even second method for this question is convert cot into tan and you can proceed, because in the denominator cots and tans are there. So the given question is 1 plus tan square A by 1 plus cot square A. Instead of doing this method, I'm doing 1 plus tan square A by 1 plus 1 by tan square A, because tan cot can be written as 1 by tan. This is 1 plus tan square A divided by tan square A plus 1 divided by tan square A. This cancel. Finally, I'm getting answer is tan square A. So the option is fourth option. Students, I hope you are clear what I done here. Can go to the next question.
Yes, sir.
Prove the following axioms. Prove the following identities where angles are involved or acute angles. That means angles are all the angles, given angles are less than 90 degrees. Then prove the following identities. If it is less than 90 degrees, because we learn only less than 90 degrees so far. That's the reason we can apply any identities what we learn. So cosecant theta minus cot theta whole square is equal to 1 minus cos theta by 1 plus cos theta. So simple. I'm taking the first identity where LHS will be equal to cosecant theta minus cot to theta whole square. So how I can write? Just expand it first. Or you can expand, or you can take sine by cos concept, like convert everything into sine and cos. It's your wish, however you want. So I'm doing both the methods. Let's see whether we are getting in both the methods easily or not. I'm expanding this one. If I'm expanding cosecant square theta plus cot square theta minus 2 cosecant theta cot theta. Cosecant square theta plus cot square theta. So cosecant square theta can be written as 1 plus cot square theta plus cot square theta minus 2 cosecant theta cot theta. So it is showing no cancellation is happening. So 1 plus 2 cot square theta minus 2 cosecant theta cot theta. It's going a little bit longer process here. So 1 plus cot square theta, how we can write 1 by tan, that is cos square theta by sine square theta, minus cosecant is 1 by sine, cot is cos by sine. So finally, I'm getting an expression is 1 plus 2 cos square theta by sine square theta minus 2 cos theta divided by sine square theta. If I'm taking the LCM, I will get sine square theta plus 2 cos square theta minus 2 cos theta divided by sine square theta. I can take 1 cos square theta out. So sine square theta plus sine square theta, cos square theta plus cos square theta minus 2 cos theta divided by sine square theta. I'm getting sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. So 1 plus cos square theta minus 2 cos theta divided by sine square theta. So this is looking like a square minus 2ab plus b square. This can be written as 1 minus cos theta whole square divided by sine square theta. We know sine square theta can be written as, because the RHS is completely in cosine. So this can be written as 1 minus cos theta whole square divided by 1 minus cos square theta. This is looking like a square minus b square format. If I'm doing that one, 1 minus cos theta whole square divided by 1 plus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta. 1 is cancelled. Finally, I'm getting 1 minus cos theta divided by 1 plus cos theta. This is like this we can do. It looks a little bit lengthy. And what is the method 2? Method 2, instead of applying some identities, right away I'm taking LHS and I'm converting into sine and cos. So second method. Cosecant theta minus cot theta whole square is my LHS. Check whether I will be able to prove. 1 by sine theta is cosecant. Cos by sine is whole square. This will be 1 minus cos theta whole square divided by sine square theta. See how much simple. Both are correct answers, but one method is giving very simplest answer. This will be 1 minus sine square theta can be written as 1 minus cos square theta. Again, 1 minus cos square theta can be written as 1 minus cos theta into 1 plus cos theta. 1 minus cancel. So finally, I'm getting 1 minus cos theta by 1 plus cos theta is your RHS. So both the methods are same. The difference is the right expression, the right conversion is important here. Both will use the answer, but one particular conversion is giving shortest way to explain the question. Hope you are clear how to do question in multiple ways, why we have to choose, why we have to practice more. Only we have to practice more because of to reduce the length of the question, length of the solution. Clear?
Yes, sir.
I'm taking the next question. Cos A by 1 plus sin A, 1 plus sin A by cos A is equal to 2 secant A. So my LHS is what here? Cos A by 1 plus sin A plus 1 plus sin A by cos A. So already they are given the sin and cos. So what we can do? We can't do anything here. Straight away take LCM first. LCM is 1 plus sin A into cos A. And this will be cos square A plus 1 plus sin A whole square. So numerator I'm expanding. Cos square A plus 1 square plus sin square A plus 2 sin A. Cos square A plus sin square A is equal to 1. So this I am not expanding, 1 plus sin A into cos A. I am keeping like this. We know in the numerator, cos square A plus sin square A can be written as 1. So 1 plus 1 plus 2 sin A divided by 1 plus sin A into cos A. 2 plus 2 sin A by 1 plus sin A into cos A. This will be, if I'm taking 2 common, 1 plus sin A divided by cos A into 1 plus sin A. 1 plus sin A, 1 plus sin A cancel. This is giving 2 by cos A, that is nothing but 2 times secant A. Hope you are clear what I done here. Students, are you clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
This question. They give the hint very clearly. Whatever the thing we are doing, that is only there, they made as a hint. One question we will do and we'll wind up the session. We'll meet in next class. Division algorithm for polynomials. Aditi, let me check one more time. I will message you. I don't think so. Division algorithm is there, but let me cross verify once. Yeah. So LHS tan theta by 1 minus cot theta plus cot theta by 1 minus tan theta. So they mentioned very clearly, convert everything into sine and cos and you will get the answer easily instead of doing. But they are asking, that means you have to do LHS separately and RHS separately. Let's see whether we can get it or not. So tan theta is sine theta by cos theta divided by 1 minus. So first what I am doing is I am converting everything into tans. Tan theta by 1 minus 1 by tan theta plus 1 by tan theta by 1 minus tan theta. This will be tan square theta by tan square theta minus 1 plus 1 by tan theta into 1 minus tan theta. So here also it is coming little bit complex, but we can say tan square theta minus 1 doesn't have any identity. That's a sure. Yeah, it's better. Sorry guys, we'll go. What are the hint he gave? So this will be sine theta by cos theta divided by 1 minus cos theta by sine theta plus this is cos theta by sine theta divided by 1 minus sine theta by cos theta. I am taking the LCM in the denominator of both the fractions, sine theta by cos theta divided by this will be sine theta minus cos theta divided by sine theta plus this will be cos theta by sine theta cos theta minus sine theta divided by cos theta. So these are the complex fractions. I am making the simplest fraction, then it will come sine will multiply with sine, sine theta by cos theta into sine theta by sine theta minus cos theta. I'll get like this plus cos theta into cos theta by sine theta into cos theta by cos theta minus sine theta. So the numerator is sine square theta by cos theta into sine theta minus cos theta plus here the numerator is cos square theta by sine theta into cos theta minus sine theta. If I am taking this is common, 1 by sine theta minus cos theta I am taking common. I will get sine square theta divided by cos theta minus cos square theta divided by sine theta. Because it is cos minus sine, this is sine minus cos. So definitely minus 1 into sine minus cos. Now I am taking LCM. 1 by sine theta minus cos theta. The LCM I am taking sine cube theta minus cos cube theta divided by sine theta into cos theta. Anyone having any answer? A cube minus b cube expansion. What is the expansion of a cube minus b cube? A cube minus b cube is a minus b into a square plus ab plus b square. Will you agree? Friends, is it correct? A cube minus b cube expansion. Will able to remember anyone from the identities of algebra? Students, please respond. Many are left. 1 by sine theta minus cos theta. Sine theta minus cos theta into sine square theta plus sin theta into cos theta plus cos square theta divided by sin theta into cos theta. So finally I am getting an expression 1 plus sin theta into cos theta divided by sin theta into cos theta. This will be 1 by sin theta into cos theta plus 1. 1 by sin is cosecant, 1 by cos is secant. So 1 plus secant theta into cosecant theta. This is my RHS. So this is how we can prove this expression. Or you can take LHS and convert everything into sine and cos. Take RHS and converting everything into sine and cos. That is also you can do. Both LHS is equal to RHS, you can able to prove. Yeah. We'll meet in next class. Bye everyone.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.